when I walk on the stage and I put my horns in the air, that's my favorite part. It's incredible to experience that and to bring joy to people around the world. And just to see the smiles and the excitement on those people's faces when we pick up that horn and blow, that's why I play music, you know, to make that feeling come alive for people and bring them to the city of New Orleans no matter where we are. And I just love it, you know, I just love it. Just to be able to play, that's all I've been able to do my whole life is just play music, and that's really a beautiful experience. Every day is surprising because you don't expect that. Like, some people don't even know what a trombone is. So for me to be out here at the level that I'm playing, that's surprising to me, even though I'm living it. When I was 4 years old, a trombone was way taller than me, to where when I would walk down the street, I would see pictures of my mom standing next to me because I would be tilting over. And that's how I got the name, you know? So it's just Trombone Shorty because the horn was much taller than me. My personal sound would have to be, of course, it's New Orleans, 100%, but there's other influences of hip-hop, rock and roll, metal music. There's like a musical gumbo of everything that we hear and everything that we experience. Super funk rock, you know, it's very, very high energy, a lot of dancing, and it can get pretty loud at some times, but it's all in good spirits and celebrating life and joy, the way that we were taught in New Orleans. My foundation, the Trombone Shorty Foundation, I created that to help the youth in the city because we have a lot of great young musicians. I just wanted to give them the opportunity to be able to learn about the music business and learn all the fundamentals of music. And I just wanted to have an impact on the city in a positive way at this moment through music to be able to help save some lives down in New Orleans. And maybe some of these young musicians can take our music to the next level. I'm not sure how I influence music, but I think I'm influencing a lot of brass players to go out there and not be afraid to rock out and not just stick to regular marching band or jazz or whatever you want to call it, but take the horns and really go up front like Miles Davis or Louis Armstrong did many years ago. As long as I'm inspiring the youth and musicians around the world, that's all I want to do, the same way that they do for me.